Okay. Good morning, everyone. Happy Friday. Welcome to Stretch and Relax. 45 minutes of pure bliss with me, Lisa Breezy, exercise physiologist, wellness heart coach, and founder of State of the Heart Fitness. I am glad that you're here, whether you're here with me on Zoom or you might be tuning in on Facebook. Fan-frickin-tastic. Just a few things. Make sure that you always listen to your body. If anything doesn't feel quite right, modify, adjust, take a rest, whatever. But this is a pretty low intensity class, just stretching and relaxing. All right, so let's do it. Let's do it. Find yourself a mat, and we're going to start off standing up. Get the music cued. All right, people, here we go. Feet shoulder width apart. We're just gonna go ahead, start swinging those arms, having a smile on our face, because there's no place we'd rather be than right here, right now. Yes. Moving our bodies. Taking in this magical moment that only passes by one time in our life. And then let's just reach those arms up over side to side. Yes, big music, powerful, passionate music that matches our spirits, our souls. Yes. Getting that body moving and flowing. Good. And then let's just take those arms and let's just do some infinities as though we're flying through the sky. Just to get that body flowing. Get those knees, those legs, those hips involved. Uh-oh. With Odessa, we never know. I don't sing her name because then she thinks I'm talking to her, and I'm not. Yes. Woo! Oh yeah. Just get the blood flowing, get that energy moving. Movement equals life. Yes. Oh, get into it, team. Let the music take you there. Yes. Excellent. And let's go ahead and take those arms up and around. Up and around. Up. Good. Shake it out. Bounce it out. Get that blood flowing. Bring those arms up. Most of you come for the entertainment more than the exercise, I know. Yes. This song just asks for us to move, to flow, to open everything up. Yes, let's just take those arms out, open. Forward and back, open, forward and open, forward. Good. And just let's just make some figure eights with those arms. Forward and back. Forward. Back. Forward. Back. Forward. Getting that spine moving, flowing. Those arms flowing, because we're glowing. Woo! Shake it out. Go with those music, the drums. Shake out those hips, shake out those arms. Arms up, over the head, big stretch, inhale. Exhale, fold forward. let's do two more. Reach it up and forward. One more. Reach up and forward. Hang out here, team. Let those arms rotate in a circle, outward circle. Breathe. Long, slow, deep breaths. Relax the neck. Let it go. And reverse. Inward circles. Yes. Notice those arms go on their own once they start. An object in motion has a tendency to stay in motion. Take note. Move those bodies. Elbow in each hand. And let's just sway side to side in a semicircle around those knees. Breathe deep and slow through the nose. Feel the stretch in the hips, opening it up. Feel the stretch in the hamstrings. Good. Drop those arms, shake up those hands, let that neck stretch. Hang out there. Breathe. And then slowly start rolling that spine up, one vertebra at a time, with your shoulders, your neck, your head. The last to come up and just roll those shoulders in a backward direction. Knees soft. Arms out. Open up the heart. Open ourselves up to this amazing day. The gift we call life. Woo! Feel that stretch. Breathe it in. Let's honor our bodies. Honor our mind, our heart, our spirit. Take your hand to your heart. Take a moment to tune in and thank yourselves for making yourself a priority, making your health a priority, for showing up for yourself, for each other. Breathe deep, shake it out. Elbow in each hand, feet wide. Sway those arms side to side. Big stretch through the shoulders. Good, get those legs involved. Rock the baby, yes. Play that violin. We've got a song called Deliverance by Yanni to open us up today. Inspiration. Yes. And let's take it all the way around in a circle. Big circles. Moving through those joints. Woo! And reverse. You know there's singing involved usually. Let's shake out those arms. Shake out the body. Oh, she gets a little out of control. Move that body. Big ending. Woo! That's the class. Thank you everybody for joining us. Just kidding. All right, moving on. Let's take our hands to our hips, and let's just go ahead and just rotate those hips around in a circle. You feel your heart? Feel that heart beating? Does your body feel a little bit warmer? That's energy. Energy flowing. Energy released from those muscles. Good. Reverse the other direction. Remember, movement equals life. Sure does. Good. Excellent. And let's take our feet together, hands on your knees, and let's just rotate those knees around. Does anybody wake up in the morning and feel a little stiff? Yikes, right? We gotta stretch. Our cats and our dogs, they stretch how many times throughout the day? Reverse the direction. It's what they do. Every time they get up, they stretch. We need to take lessons from them. They are instructors, not just in stretching, but in a lot of ways, right? Being present, being joyful. Excellent. And roll up. Let's take our feet shoulder width apart, hands on our thighs, and we're just going to move our spine. I'm going to show you the side view. Inhale, arch, tilt the tailbone back. Exhale, tailbone underneath, round out your back, spread your shoulder blades. Inhale, arch, lengthen. Exhale, round it out. Inhale, arch, lengthen. Exhale, round it out. Inhale, arch, lengthen. Exhale, round it out. Let's do a couple more, team. Inhale, arch. Exhale, round it out. One more. Inhale, arch. Exhale, round it out. I'm going to show you the front view. Now I want you to just drop your right, your left shoulder down. And then reverse. Our other side, right shoulder. And then let's just alternate. Left and right. Left and right. Left and right. And let's roll ourselves up in the center. Fantastic job, everybody. We're going to do some hip openers. So, you can stand with your hands against the wall or a chair if you need to, or just practice your balance. And we're just going to take one leg and we're going to do some leg swings, hip openers. Okay? Keep your standing leg slightly bent. Our hips store a lot of energy, a lot of stuck energy. Especially if we sit a lot throughout the day, those hips get really tight. So really important to open it up. When those muscles get tight, that connective tissue, the tendons, the ligaments, tendons attach muscles to bone, ligaments attach bone to bone, and the fascia, which is the sinewy cobweb-like material that goes through every muscle fiber. That all gets a little bit rigid. When that gets tight, it affects our posture, starts pulling on our spine, our pelvis, and we start feeling pain, tension. Good. Excellent. And let's go ahead and switch to the other side. Open up those hips. How we doing out there, team? Thumbs up? No place you'd rather be? I get it. I understand. Good. Forward and back. Big hip swings. Good. Now we're going to do the same kind of thing, just changing the angle. I'm going to just hold on, but we're going to do side leg swings as I'm kicking my ball. I love playing kickball as a kid. Anybody play kickball?
Boom!
Good. Side leg swings. Now remember, always listen to your body. If something doesn't quite feel right to you, modify, adjust. It's not about keeping up with me or whatever. We're all on our own journey. And our body will tell us a story. It'll let us know what it's up for. Good. Let's go ahead and switch to the other side. Yes, side leg swings. Taking some long, slow, deep breaths. Inhale through the nose. Exhale through the nose of the mouth. Breathing is really important. Of course, that's kind of like the obvious duh, breathing. We don't breathe, we're not here. But with stretching, good. Go ahead and shake it out. With stretching, breathing through the nose, diaphragmatic breaths into the chest, into the abdomen, stimulates the relaxation response in the nervous system. A lot of times we're in the fight or flight, breathing short, shallow breaths or holding our breath. So breathing deep and slow, opens things up, signals to the body to release and let go. Okay? All right, let's go ahead. We're gonna just do a little yoga stretch here. Take those feet wide, wider than the shoulders, much wider. Take those arms out. Draw your shoulder blades together, heart is forward. Tuck the pelvis underneath, tuck the tailbone a little bit so you squeeze those glutes a little bit. Okay, and then we're gonna turn our left foot, okay, to the left. And we're gonna turn our gaze to the left. And we're gonna lean in to that knee, okay? You wanna make sure that your left foot is far enough in front of you so that that knee is over the heel, not over the toes, okay? Protect those knees. And then we're gonna reach into that left hand. Remember, turn your gaze over the fingertips, anchor into that right foot, breathe deep and slow.
So you think you can tell
heaven from hell. This is heaven, right? Good, breathe deep and slow.
Can you tell a green field?
You guys are amazing. We are honoring our amazing vehicle that allows our soul to shine in this lifetime. It's called our body. Let's take that left elbow to the left knee. Right hand, palm up and reach it over. Big stretch, open up that rib cage. Smiles on those faces, drop a little bit deeper into that lunge. Deep breaths through the nose. Again, any of you joining us on Facebook, we are happy to have you here. Live, stretch and relax on Friday mornings. My Zoomers are with me. Woo! And come back up to center. Straighten out. Bring that left foot in. Turn that right foot to the right. Turn your gaze over your hands. Drop into that lunge. Remember, make sure that right foot is far enough out so that your knee is over your heel, not over your toes. And then we're just going to reach into those fingertips. Keep that left foot anchored and hold. Draw the shoulder blades together. Open the heart. Breathe deep and slow. How I wish you were here. And if you're here, great. Two lost souls in a fishbowl, yes. Take that right elbow to the right knee. Reach that left arm over. Big stretch. Anchor in to that left foot. Drop a little bit deeper. Hold.
Wish you were here.
I noticed I have my alma mater on my shirt today, Pepperdine University. Yes, I was a Pepperdine Wave many, many, many years ago. Woo! Little Minnesota girl. Had a dream of moving to California, going to college out here. Didn't think I'd ever be at Pepperdine, but as life would have it, miracles would have it, that's where I ended up. All right, let's go ahead, walk those feet in. How we feeling, team? Woo! Let's just anchor here. Let's take a deep breath in. Inhale those arms up. Exhale, float the arms down. Good, inhale up. Exhale, float the arms down. Good, and one more. Inhale up. And exhale down. Fantastic, we're gonna come down to the floor. Take your stronger leg forward. Brace yourself with your hands, lower the back knee down. And the other knee, let's come on to all fours. Hands spread underneath those shoulders. We're gonna take that left arm and reach it up toward the ceiling or the sky. Opening up the chest. Breathing deep and slow through that nose. You might feel a little shaking in your body. It's okay. Your body is working. And that shaking is growth, change, stretching, open up. Good. opening our bodies and our minds. Yes, bring it back down. Fantastic job. Let's do the other side. Take that right arm up.
If you could read my mind, love,
open it up.
What do my thoughts
take your gaze mean? Up to your hand, just reaching up toward the sky. Breathe deep and slow.
In a castle dark or a fortress strong.
Good, and then bring it back down. Fantastic job. We're just going to do a down dog here. So you're going to curl your toes under. Now remember, always do what feels right to you. If something doesn't feel right, modify, adjust, or take a rest, okay? Curl those toes under, spread those fingers, and pull the tailbone up toward the sky. Draw up into those heels. Press your chest toward your thighs. Relax your neck, roll the chin, shoulder to shoulder, let it go.
When you reach the pause, where the heartaches come,
the hero would be you. Yes, we are all heroes within our own lives. We've all survived a lot of things. No matter how challenging life has been, you're here. In this moment, you've survived. You are a survivor. You're a thriver. Let's bend one knee, drop into the other heel, and switch. So take a moment to really ponder all the things that have challenged you in your life, things that you didn't know you were going to get through. But guess what? This moment proves that you got through. I choose to see that everything that happens in life is for us, not against us, no matter what it is. It's all about growth. It's all about life saying, there's more here for you, but I gotta squeeze you a little bit to get the juice out, right? Let's drop into the heels, come down to the knees. Sit back into child's pose. Reach those arms out. So yeah, when life is putting the squeeze on you, so to speak,
if you could read my
it's easy to think of, why is this happening to me? Feeling like a victim. Let's face it, we all have those moments. But if we reframe it, and we say, what is the opportunity here? What is life trying to show me, teach me? Because there's more to me than meets the eye that we've been demonstrating. So life is just trying to squeeze that juice out of us and say, I see you. There's more here. Come on up. Excellent. Let's go into cat, cow. So tilt the tailbone up, lengthen, breathe deep. Exhale, tailbone tuck, chin tuck, pull the navel in. Feeling's gone and I just can't get it back. And inhale, extend. Exhale, round it out. Inhale, extend. Exhale, round it out. You guys are amazing. How we feeling out there? Inhale, extend. Exhale, round it out. All right, team, we're gonna work our glutes, stretch our glutes a little bit. So what I want you to do, walk your hands forward a little bit and take your right leg and bring it underneath you as far as you can, as high as you can, as close to your hands as you can. Your back leg, toes face down, push it back, okay? Now, you can just stay here on your hands with your back upright. You should feel that stretch in your right glute. You might also feel it in your left hip. Breathe deep and slow. Kind of shift your hips side to side. Find the spot that your body says, yes, this is where I need it the most. Is it in the glute or is it in the hip? And then if you want to, if you can, you don't have to. You can take it down to your forearms if your flexibility allows for that. We're not comparing ourselves to anyone. Everybody's on their own journey. Okay? Our body is on its own journey. and to compare it to somebody else and say, well, look at where they are compared to me, and then become self-critical does not serve. Okay? Let's love our body. It's doing the best it can for where it is and for what we've all done to it. All right, if you can, reach those arms out a little further. Go a little bit deeper into that stretch. Remember, these are just options. Listen to your body. Any sharp shooting pains are your body's sign of no. That's too far, too much for me today. It's all about learning a healthy, loving, harmonious relationship with your body. How many of you have a loving, harmonious, healthy relationship with your body? I'm going to say that well over 90% of people do not. Because we are not taught that from little on. And I have my theories on that. And definitely my thoughts. I know you're shocked. Lisa has thoughts on something. Let's go ahead and walk yourself up and bring yourself out of that. How did we do? Woo! What we do to one side, we must do to the other. Take that left leg. Bring it up as far underneath you as you can, as close to your hands. Your back leg, push it back. Toes face down. Okay, stay on your hands. Kind of shift your hips side to side. Where do you need it the most? Where does your body say yes best? Where the tightness is? Is it in your glute? Or is it in your opposite hip flexor? Okay, breathe deep and slow. And then if you can, come down to your forearms. Breathe deep. Your breath is key here. Long, slow, deep breaths as you relax into it. Remember, your breath and how you manage your breath signals to the body what it should do, what it should feel. Holding our breath, short, shallow breaths, signals to the nervous system we are in stress. Fight, flight, or freeze. But in this moment, we are not in stress. So breathing deep and slow through the nose, into the lungs, into the abdomen. Signals to the body, we can relax, we are safe right here, right now. There is peace in the present. So yes, our body, the most miraculous entity there is. It's a universe in and of itself. And yet we abuse it and use it, and we get annoyed with it when we feel it doesn't work for us. When really our body is just trying to communicate to us. Our soul is trying to communicate to us through our body. Are we paying attention? I've done a talk in the past called Your Body is an Instrument. Are you in tune? Most of the time we're not, because we're directing our energy outside into the outer world. We're allowing ourselves to get taken up by the whirlwind of the stress of the outer world. Let's walk ourselves up and out. Excellent job. Sit back into child's pose one more time. And when we're caught up in the outside world and the news and all of that, what somebody else is doing, we are ignoring the communication that's happening from our soul through our body. We're all in our heads. And where we put our attention and our energy is what we experience. So if you put your attention outward all the time on the news headlines, do we wonder why we feel like crap about ourselves, about the world, about each other? It's about turning our focus inward on our beautiful soul, our heart, our body. Let's go ahead and let's come out and let's sit with our legs crossed. How are we feeling so far, team? You guys are amazing. Hands on the knees. We're going to inhale, bring the heart forward, arch the back. Exhale, round it out, tuck the chin. Inhale, arch. Exhale, round it out. So remember, your body is the vehicle that your soul chose in this lifetime to radiate and shine your divine light to the world. Yep, own it. That's what's going on here. Good. And now let's do some Sufi grinds with your belly button. You're just drawing a circle on the floor, or you can imagine a little spoon stirring in the pelvic bowl, getting that spine flowing. Breathing deep and slow. Back is tall, shoulders relaxed, eyes closed. So you can really turn in and tune in and reverse the direction. When we close our eyes, it allows us to bring our focus inward and really connect with our body. Hear what it's saying to us. Good, and then back is tall. Take a moment, eyes closed, just bow the head down, shoulders away from your ears, draw your shoulder blades together. Take some deep breaths here. Take your hands to your heart. Bless your beautiful physical heart that pumps the blood, the life force through you. Bless your emotional heart that allows us to feel emotions. Emotions are energy in motion. Makes us feel alive. Bless our spiritual heart that reminds us that we are all one, a part of the whole. We are not orphans in this world. We are here together. And what we do affects the world. Deep breath in, exhale. Let's come onto our backs. How are we doing, team? We're getting closer to our relaxation part. Yay, right? Let's hug the knees into our chest. Just stretch that lower back and gently rock side to side. Give yourself a little back massage. Remember, just loving and honoring our body. And take note of how maybe in the past you haven't treated your body so well. Remember, everything that we put in our mouths, food is either medicine or poison. All the thoughts that we have about ourselves, about our body, are they positive and encouraging, or are they negative and discouraging? Are we our own self-critic? Yes, we are. How loving are we to ourselves, to our body, when our body's just doing the best it can for what we give it? Hands on the knees, rotate the knees around together in a circle. Massaging that lower back, and then reverse. Eyes closed. Breathing deep and slow. You guys are amazing. You are a miracle. Our body is a miracle. All right, let's go ahead and keep that right knee in. Extend that left leg onto the ground. Hug it in. And then with your left hand, bring it across your body to the left side. Right arm extends. Turn your head over the right shoulder. Keep the shoulder blades flat. Feel the stretch across the chest, down the spine, into that right hip. Breathe deep and slow. Deep, nourishing, healing breaths. Breathing that energy into every cell of your being, from the toes to the top of your head to the fingertips. Breath in. Exhale, bring that knee up. Extend that leg. Hug the left leg in. Hug that knee. With your right hand, bring that leg across to the right side. Left arm extends onto the floor. Turn your head over that left shoulder. Keep the shoulder blades flat. Stretch across the chest, down the spine, into the left glute, left flow. Breath in. Exhale, bring that knee back up and extend that leg onto the ground. Let's take those arms down, palms up, palms down, whatever feels right. Or if you want to rest your hands on your heart, whatever feels right to you. And we're just going to move into our relaxation portion of class for the last 8 minutes or so. I want you just to lie quietly and peacefully. And I want you to feel the earth beneath you totally supporting you. Can you allow yourself to be held? To be totally supported? Allow yourself to let go, to release. Breathing deep and slow through the nose, down deep into the lungs, deep into the heart space, even deeper into the belly as you breathe in. I want you to imagine your rib cage and your belly expanding. As you exhale, draw the navel towards your spine, feel the contraction of the abdominals, and then exhale, letting go of any tension in your body. So inhale deeply, deep into the lungs, the heart, the belly. Exhaling, letting it go. As you allow yourself to release, let go and relax a little bit deeper. Allow yourself to be supported and held by the earth. Each breath allowing you to go a little bit deeper into that place within yourself, that place of inner peace, that place of inner stillness. Visualize the heart space, that sanctuary, that inner sanctuary that lies deep within your soul, that the outside world cannot touch. It is your place of inner peace, your place of inner joy, the place of your inner child where you can just play and frolic. Body. For your heart, your mind, your soul. For this moment. The gift of the present. I want you just to bring your awareness as you continue to breathe in and feel that appreciation and gratitude and joy. Just remember that our cells hear everything that we think, and they feel everything that we feel. Depending on the thoughts we have and the feelings we have, it changes our physiology. With those thoughts that bring us a sense of joy and gratitude, it allows our body to relax, release, and heal. when we bring our thoughts to things that bring us agitation, irritation, anger, it changes how our body responds physiologically, and it puts us into a stress response. So focus on those feelings of joy and appreciation, gratitude. Breathe it in. Now I want you to take your awareness to your toes, to your fingers, to the top of your head. And we're going to bring tension into our body. So curl your toes, squeeze your feet, bring the tension into your calves, into your quads, your hamstrings, into your glutes, practically lifting your lower back off the floor. Take your hands, making them into fists. Bring the tension into the forearm, the biceps, the triceps, the shoulder. Lift those shoulders and those arms up off the floor. Squeeze as tight as you can, and then bring the tension up into your face. Squeeze your cheeks, lower your eyebrows, pierce your lips, shrug your shoulders to your ears, and just feel that tension and just hold it, hold it, hold it, exaggerate it. Squeeze a little bit tighter. Come on. Deep breath in. Exhale, deep breath. Open up the fingers. Gently let those arms float to the ground. Let your body settle back into the earth. Feel the tension flow out through your toes, through your fingertips, and you allow the earth to absorb any tension in your body. If you want to visualize that tension as a color and visualize and see that color just melting into the earth and away from your body, as you allow yourself to be held and taken care of. Breathing deep and slow, find that inner peace. Hands on your heart, bow the head down, eyes closed. Feel the peace, feel the energy. Let's take this energy into the world today and make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. When we heal our heart, we heal the world. Deep breath. That concludes our class today of Stretch and Relax. My name is Lisa Breezy. Thank you so much for joining me, whether you're live on Zoom or if you're on Facebook. If any of you felt this was a benefit to your day and you feel inclined to give a donation, I totally appreciate that. But if you can't give a donation, I say give to the world today in whatever way you can. Okay? I will be teaching movement, mindfulness, and meditation at 8 o'clock Pacific time on Monday, if you'd like to join me for that. And then on Wednesdays, I have strength and balance, a 30-minute class. So reach out to me if you have any other questions. And if you'd like to stay on for a chat, please do. Otherwise, have a fantastic day and weekend. And I hope to see you next time. All right. Bye, everyone.